describe what PCM is?
Yeah, so PCM is basically a material that we utilize one of its phase changes. Generally, it's going to be solid to liquid, so think of a wax. As you apply heat and it's approaching its melt temperature, it starts going through its phase change, and then it's starting to use that energy towards its latent heat of fusion. So you can store a significant amount of heat across that phase change that if you were in sensible heating would just cause a fairly significant temperature increase. But because it's absorbing it through the phase change, you're not really seeing any temperature increase as you're inputting more energy into the system.
So Ryan, we've been seeing a lot of interest from our customers about using PCM, a new technology that we don't have heritage with currently, to put it on their satellites. Is that something that you see being a benefit?
Well, the easy answer is yes, right? So there's several things that you can find attractive from phase change material heat sinks, one of which is it's passive. It doesn't have anything moving fluid. It doesn't have a pump. It has very few joints. So it's low maintenance. If it works here, it survives launch. It'll work in orbit. Generally, that's going to be used for pulsed applications. Mm-hmm. So anything that has a duty cycle, something that's 50% or below use. So if you're hitting your amplifier for 10% of the orbit, PCM is a great solution. And rather than the radiator panel seeing the full brunt of that heat load, it sees the time average load. Mm-hmm. So you can get a significantly smaller radiator panel and corresponding mass reduction.
So when would you use these in low Earth orbit or missions to the moon? When would I see this?
That's great question. It really depends on your environment. I know a lot of the interest we're getting right now is oriented more so towards the low Earth orbit. Mm-hmm. I know that there's some additional thermal challenges whenever it comes to manned missions to the moon or just missions to the moon, where there are some additional reflective radiation that's in the spacecraft that can cause some thermal challenges. Suffice it to say, it's going to depend on your environment. Like I said, if it's something that's duty cycled, or you just need to absorb a certain amount or a certain duration, mm-hmm. it's a very good application.
So what's one place that PCM would be a really good fit that maybe someone wouldn't know right off the bat?
I guess one potential opportunity for PCM is if you have solder joints that are going through fairly significant temperature swings, it can be used to dampen that and potentially inhibit some of the solder fatigue issues you might see on some of your components, more on the board level than anything. So that's one, I guess, application that might not be completely evident, but it is something that may be worthwhile of looking into.
So Ryan, what would be the benefit of using a PCM over a more traditional cooling solution in space?
It's going to be contingent on your application. So if you have something that's duty cycled and you're inputting a lot of power over 10 minutes and then you're off for 80, using a heat pipe is going to take all that power directly to your radiator panel, or even just relying on conduction. Versus phase change material, if you put that as a link in between the radiator panel and your source and the resistance network, it's going to first absorb that heat, and the radiator panel is just going to see the time average, basically heat load or energy coming out of the system. So you get a much smaller radiator panel for the same application. Fairly tremendous in terms of mass savings, depending on the application.
And why is it important to save mass on a spacecraft or satellite?
Mass is expensive.